Hello, good evening everyone. Today we are going to discuss the next set of questions from the BHU MSc Chemistry Entrance Examination previous question papers. So the first question is from physical chemistry, and the question is, this question goes like this. The plots of gaseous densities versus temperature and of liquid densities versus temperature for a substance converge at a temperature. The temperature is called, the answer is option 3, critical temperature. So what does the question actually means? It means that is at a certain temperature, gas density is equal to liquid density. That is the question. And this temperature at which this thing is possible is known as the critical temperature. So what happens? As the temperature is increased, the liquid gets heated and liquid gets transformed to gas. And as a result, the density of gas will be increasing and the density of liquid will be decreasing. And when liquid density decreases and gas density increases, and at a certain temperature, these become equal. And that temperature is the critical temperature. I hope you understood this part. Now we will go to the second question. The second question here is, the RMS velocity of helium gas at 0 degrees Celsius is given. We need to find the most probable speed of the gas. There are multiple methods to do these kinds of questions. That is, we can either, you know, what is the equation of VRMS? VRMS is equal to root of 3 RT by M. And V most probable, I am writing it as MP. V most probable will be equal to root of 2 RT by M. We can either substitute all these values and find the answer, or we have a simpler method. When I have taken the part of gaseous state, I have already given you the ratio between RMS most probable velocity and also the average velocity. So if you remember, V most probable is to V RMS, V is equal to root 2 is to root 3. So, or we can write it this way, V most probable divided by V RMS will be equal to root 2 by root 3. Therefore, what will be V most probable? V most probable will be equal to root 2 into V RMS divided by root 3. Now, the approximate value of root 2 will be equal to 1.414, and RMS velocity is given here. It is given as 1300, and the root 3, that is given, that would be approximately 1.73. If we calculate using this value, our answer would be option D, 1061.4 meter per second. We can, without any doubt, we can use this equation, because both RMS and because we have the RMS value and we already know the ratio, so we can definitely use this particular equation. Okay, now we will be going to the next question. The next question is from inorganic chemistry. Here the question is, CuI2 is unstable because it is readily decomposes to. This is a very simple question. Most of you might know this without even reading or wasting much time. We can directly write this answer. So Cu2 will be giving 2Cu(I) plus I2 gas. This I2 will be liberated. So this is the equation. So what will be our answer if we are going through the options? Option 3 would be our answer. CuI2 is unstable because it is readily decomposes to CuI and I2. The fourth question here is, which one of the following is an example of sandwich compound? Here we are, this is chromium, not cobalt. CrC6H6 twice is there. CrCO6 is there. Cr2CH3COOO twice is there. Then PtNH3 twice, PtCl4 is given. Definitely our answer is option A, CrC6H6. And what is the name of this particular compound? Complex, sorry, not compound, it's a complex. Bis, then in bracket we'll be having benzene, chromium. This is the bis, benzene, chromium. This is sometimes also called as dibenzene chromium. Dibenzene chromium. We can write this as so this would be the structure of this particular compound. It's a sandwich compound like ferrocene, and the oxidation state of chromium here is zero. The oxidation state is zero since benzene here is a neutral ligand, so oxidation state would be zero. So this is an example of arene complexes. One of the major example is arene complexes, that is arene sandwich compounds. Sandwich compound, this is the example. Okay, now we'll go to the next question. Here, the question is, which one of the following is the structure of auxine? So, the major thing that you have to know is that auxine is an important reagent, because it is a chelating agent used for quantitative determination of metal ions. And therefore, the structure is important, and the structure is option B. This question was asked in 2015 and also 2016. The same question was repeated. So, you can always expect these kinds of questions again, because these are always important in the field of qualitative analysis. I mean, quantitative analysis. So, definitely, these type of organic reagents are always important, and you should know the structure of these compounds. Now, what is the structure we have already seen? And there is another name for the auxine, that is 8-hydroxyquinoline. 8-hydroxyquinoline. And why is it called 8-hydroxyquinoline? Because we can see, if you are starting to number, it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. The OH group is in the 8th position, then we have 9 and 10 here. So, this is how we number quinoline, and since the OH is at the 8th position, and therefore it is 8-hydroxyquinoline. So, what is this? So, this is a chelating agent, and it is used for the quantitative determination of metal ions. So, this is really important. The next question here asked is, the reagent used in the following transformation is? So, we can carefully look at the question, and then we will go to the options. So, here we have a carbonyl group, and here also we have a carbonyl group. This carbonyl group is a ketone, and this carbonyl group is a part of an ester. Now, we will be going to the product. What happened to both the carbonyl groups? Here, the ester carbonyl group remains as such. There is no change in the carbonyl group of ester, but the carbonyl group of ketone has been converted to alcohol. So, what we can see? Now, we will go to the options. First, we have lithium aluminium hydride. Lithium aluminium hydride is not selective, and it can reduce both. So, as I have said, lithium aluminium hydride is not selective. It can reduce ketone also into alcohol, and also it will reduce the ester carbonyl also. Now, we already know that these two, the Wolff-Kirchner reagent and the Clemmensen reagent, both will not convert this carbonyl group into alcohol. Instead, they will be converting it into alkane. So, these two are not the answer, because these will reduce CO into CH2. And this is the Wolff-Kirchner reagent, and this is the Clemmensen reagent. So, definitely our answer will be NaBH4, because this is selective and it reduces only ketone and aldehyde. So, this is our answer. Lithium aluminium hydride reduces both ketone and ester. And in our reaction, only the ketone got reduced, and also that ester carbonyl group is remaining as such. So, CO to CHOH. Okay. So, I hope you understood this one. We will be first of all looking at these type of questions to find the reagent when it comes. Carefully look at the reactant and product and identify what are the changes that occurred here. And then go and find which one of the reagents given in the options matches our particular conversion. Okay. This is a very simple question from the part of quantum mechanics. Here, the operator is asked. So, as I have already already said, in case of quantum mechanics, the things that can be asked are, one will be the energy of particle in a one-dimensional box, then different operator representation and commutators. These three topics are extremely important, and most probably 99% of the times only questions from these three parts will be asked for you. So you should be thorough with all these three and only then go attend the questions from quantum mechanics, else don't attend the questions because you are definitely going to get negative. Don't make negatives in the question. So when you have only little amount of work things to learn, please don't please don't be lazy to learn those, because it will be giving you easy marks. Now we'll be seeing what each the representation of each operators are. First of all, let me tell the answer of this question is kinetic energy minus h bar square 2 by 2m d square by dx square is the representation of kinetic energy. But I will be also introducing to you the representations of other important operators, that is other important operators also I'll be explaining. For position, it will be x. Position is x. Then potential energy, PE, it will be equal to V of x. Potential energy will be represented as V of x. Then kinetic energy, we know it is like this. So the total energy will be equal to, total energy will be equal to minus h cross square by 2m do square by dou x square plus V of x. We know total energy should be the sum of kinetic energy and potential energy. So total energy will be the sum of these two. Then what do we have? Linear momentum. Linear momentum will be represented as h cross by I dou by dou x. This is the representation of linear momentum. And angular momentum, consider if we have Lz, that is the angular momentum through the z-axis, it will be represented as h cross by I x dou by dou y minus y dou by dou x. So these are the major representation, and you should memorize these, because without this is simple to learn, and if you don't know this, it will be difficult for you to attend the questions from quantum mechanics. So that's it. Now we'll be going to the next question. The next question asked here is, which of the following is not the product of osmolysis of citral? So let's see the structure of citral. Citral is represented like this. This is citral, and after the osmolysis, three major products are formed. One is this. So what is this? This is glyoxal. Glyoxal, and definitely glyoxal is formed. And the second product will be like this, which is acetone, and it is option 2. Then the third one will be, it is represented like this, and it is called linylaldehyde. This is also there. So what is not formed during the osmolysis of citral is acetaldehyde. In these three products you cannot see acetaldehyde, so definitely our answer should be option 3, acetaldehyde, because other three, acetone, glyoxal and linylaldehyde, are all the three are formed when osmolysis of citral takes place. So I would suggest you to just memorize the structure of citral, because usually questions from this part comes more for BHU. They prefer questions from biomolecules a lot. So it would be advisable for you to learn the structure of citral. At least try to memorize it so that you can identify if it comes as an option. So that's it with this question. Now we'll go to the next question. The reactant M in the reaction given below. So since you have seen NaNH2 and liquid NH3, definitely this would be an elimination addition reaction or benzene mechanism. Elimination addition or benzene mechanism. So let's see. First we will be starting with O bromo anisole. OCH3 means O bromo. Here bromine is there. What would happen? So in the first step, there will be a hydrogen will be abstracted and the carbanion will be formed. Negative charge will be formed here. Sorry, I will be rewriting this. I will be rewriting the double bonds to make it more easier to write. So we have CH3 and we have Br here. This negative charge will be coming here and the bromine will be leaving and we will be getting benzene. We have benzene here. So in the next step, in case of OCH3, the negative charge is always stabilized in the ortho position. So definitely the nucleophile will be coming. Nucleophile here is NH2. NH2 will be always attacking the meta position because this negative charge is easier to shift into the ortho position. So what will happen? In the next step, we'll be having the nucleophile, that is here NH2 in this position, and the double bond will be shifting to the ortho position. Then hydrogen will be abstracted and we will be getting this product. We'll be getting the product asked in the question. So definitely O-bromoanisole can form this particular product. So the option can be either 1 or 3. Now we have to check M-bromoanisole to understand whether the whether it can also give this particular product. So let's see. We have OCH3, and in case of meta, here we will be having the bromine. And as I have already said, see, even though it can form negative charge here and here, the OCH3 group can stabilize negative charge in the ortho position. So negative will be formed here. This will be coming and bromine will be leaving and we will be having benzene here, OCH3. And again, as we have said here, the nucleophile will be attacking this position so that the negative charge will be going to the ortho position and can stabilize the negative charge. So definitely both these O-bromoanisole and M-bromoanisole both can form this particular product. Sorry, here it is NH2. O-bromoanisole and M-bromoanisole both can form the product given in the question. So, and option 3 would be the right answer. And this negative charge will be, what will happen to this negative charge? Will be abstracting hydrogen and hydrogen will come there. So, we'll be having NH2. So, our product will be this in both the cases of O-bromoanisole and also M-bromoanisole. So the final question of today is from the nuclear reactor part. And here the question is, graphite is used in nuclear reactors as which of the following? And you already know this is a well-known fact that it is used to reduce the velocity of neutron. And why do we need to reduce the velocity of neutrons? Because if the velocity is not reduced, these neutrons will be moving so fast that the chain reaction will not occur. We have the neutron should have only a limited velocity so that it can encounter again and the fuel again and again and continue the reaction without much as such. That is the chain reaction. In order to the chain reaction to occur in the nuclear reactors, we need to have the neutron velocity reduced. For that, we use graphite. So we have discussed 10 questions today as well. I hope this is helping you for the preparation in case of MSc chemistry entrance examination of BHU. So please do continue your preparation in a very good manner. If you have any doubt, please ask in the comment section. We are going to make videos about BHU. I know the exams of BHU and BITSAT are coming before CUSET and Pondicherry University and even Delhi University. So we'll be making more videos of BHU and BITSAT before your exams. Don't worry about that. You can. I hope you all score very good marks and get the highest ranks in your examination. Thank you for watching. Subscribe our channel. Hit the bell icon for latest updates. And thank you. Have a good day to you all.